Hey, what's up guys? This is Vikas once again back with another tutorial. In this tutorial I will show you how to create a three-step infographics like this in just PowerPoint guys. So as you can see here, I have created a single element and it's looking like it's something upward to the surface and giving a pleasant effect guys. It's looking so attractive, beautiful and eye-catching guys. So let me show you how I have arranged the different element and group it to get a shape like this, or we can say that effect like this. So I'm going to ungroup it and I'm going to show you how I have arranged the different element. So I'm going to ungroup a single element like this, and now you can see the different parts of this infographics. I have arrange these parts and combine these shapes and as well as the text to give a effect like this guys. Okay, but before start creating guys, I just want to request you, if you are new on this channel and watching this video for the first time, then do subscribe this channel and press the bell icon so that you'll get notified whenever we upload a new video on this channel. Okay, so now it's time to create it guys. So I'm going to undo it and let me insert a blank slide over here. So I'm going to click on insert option over here, and now you can see the new slide option over here. Just click on that and choose a blank slide like this. Okay, so now the first thing I'm going to do is to create this single element, and after duplicating this element 3 times we'll get the whole infographics like this. Okay, so let me create it first. So the first thing I'm going to do is I will click on insert option, click on shape option, and here you will find the round shape, side corner rectangle. This is the long name of the shape. Probably you don't remember or recall it, but keep in mind that you should select a shape with 2 round corners. Okay, so you have to select this particular shape, click on this and drag it like this. Rotate it 90 degree right like this, and now I'm going to remove the outlines. As you can see, the outlines are there, dark blue outlines are there. So I'm going to remove it by clicking on this option, and here you will find a no outline option over here. So just click on that to remove the outline. Okay, now I'm going to decrease the size of this shape and increasing the width of the shape like this, and now I'll put it over here. So now you can see 2 yellow handles over here. If you adjust this handle like this, then you will get a round corner at the left side. But I'm not going to do any changes with this yellow dot. I'm going to do changes with this dot. So I'm going to make it something this much rounded. Okay, so now it's complete. Let me take the reference of the previous slide. So now what we have to create guys, so let me take the reference of the previous slide. So now I'm going to duplicate this slide by pressing Ctrl D and put it separately like this. And now what I'm going to do, I will click on again, I will duplicate this shape and put it separately, and let me fill it with a different color. So I'm going to fill it with this color. I'm going to rotate, flip it horizontally, and now I will rotate it like this. Okay, so now I will put this shape over the previous shape. Like I'm going to put it over this shape and increase the height like this and put it over here guys, as you can see here. So I will put it over here like this. Slightly I'm going to increase it, right click over here, click on format shape option, and make this shape transparent so that we can see the whole changes going there. So I'm going to increase the transparency like this, and now slightly I'm going to increase the height like this. Right click over here on the transparent shape and choose edit point option. You will get the dots over here. So we don't need to change this with any dot, but I'm going to change this with this dot, and slightly I'm going to slide it to the right, and I'm going to drag this yellow white handles something here guys. Okay, or maybe something here, and this I'm going to, sorry, and now I'm going to move this shape something here. Sorry, I'll put the shape over here and click on this shape, press Ctrl and click on this shape and extract the shape from the previous shape. So we'll rest with this shape size. Okay, so I'm going to fill it with a different color, like I'm going to choose this color for now. Later on we will change the color and put it over here, guys. Okay, so this shape is ready. Now it's time to create this shape. Look, this shape is ready, guys. So I'm going to create this shape. So to do that, what I'm going to do, I will again duplicate this shape and flip it horizontally. So I'm going to click on format option. Here you will find the rotate option. Just click on that and say flip horizontal. And now I'm going to decrease the size, like I'm going to do it this much, something this much, okay, and put it over here. Okay guys, or maybe here. So you have to put it over here, guys. Now it's time to join these two shapes with a shape, formatted shape. We have to format the shape here. So to do that, I'm going to click on insert option, and here I will go, I will choose the rectangle option over here and drag a random rectangle like this, remove the outline and fill it with a different color for now. Later on we will change the color. So I'm going to put it over here and I'm going to slide it here so that we can match the edges with the previous shape. Now right click on the red rectangle and click on edit point option. Before doing this, I'm going to decrease it. Right click over here, click on edit point option, just put this point over here. Let me zoom in, guys, so that we can see the corner very well. So I'm going to put it over here and I'm going to drag this point something here, guys. Okay, so after zoom in, you can see the corner is not matched with the this shape. So we have to match this corner. Okay, so I'm going to reduce the height like this, and now I'm going to decrease the width like this. And now it's time to match these two corners, this corner for the upper side and this corner from the lower side. Right click, just click edit point option and drag this point here at this corner and drag this point here at this corner. So I'm going to match it, like I'm going to do it something this much. Okay, okay guys, so I'm going to zoom out. Now it's fine, guys. So now it's time to fill it with the color. So I'm going to click on the previous slide, and here you will find some color palette I have collected here. So I'm going to copy this color palette or paste it over the new slide like this. And now I'm going to fill it with the color. So for this shape, I'm going to choose a gradient fill option over here, and the type should be linear and the direction should be this one, or maybe this one. I will alternate the handles like this because we want a darker color at the bottom and lighter color at the upper side. So for the darker color, sorry, for the lighter color first, we'll choose the lighter color. So I'm going to choose an eyedropper and choose this color for the upper side, and for the lower side, I'm again going to choose this color. But as you know, we have to choose a darker version of the green color. So I'm going to click on the color option. Here you will find the more color option. Just click on that and choose darker color. To choose the darker color, you just have to track this arrow down to get a darker color from this particular color group. So now I'm going to click on OK and I'm going to track this here to get a darker color at this side, as you can see, guys. Okay, so this is how we have to fill the color, guys. Now it's time to fill the color with from this shape. Before doing this, I'm going to right click over here, format the background, choose a gradient fill option, and it will automatically fetch the color from the previous slide, as you can see here, because I recently added these two colors to the slide. So it will automatically fetch the color, as you can see, For the right handle, I'm using this particular color, and for the left handle, I'm using a white color, guys. So this is very easy. So now I'm going to fill this shape with the color. So I'm going to choose this color for this shape, or maybe some darker color. So I'm going to choose this color, or let me choose some another color. Like I'm going to choose a little bit lighter color. So I'm going to choose this color for this. Okay, now for this, I'm again going to fill it with the same color. So I'm going to choose this color, and for this, I'm going to choose the same color. Let me take the reference of the previous slide, guys. Okay. Okay, so for this, you have to choose a gradient fill option over here, and the type should be linear. And the direction foot should be in the left to the right, guys. And let me change the angle, like we have to do it something like this. For the right handle, I'm going to choose this darker color, and for the left handle, I'm going to choose the lighter gray color, like this. Okay. And now let me change the angle like this, guys, as you can see here. Let me take the reference of the previous slide, guys. Okay, so we have to choose some more darker color, guys. So I'm going to choose more color option and drag it downward to make some darker color and fill it with this color, guys. Okay, and now I will use the same color for this shape. Some darker color for this shape, guys. Okay, now you can see the effect. Okay, so now it's time to add some shadow effect over here. So to do that, what I'm going to do, I will click on insert option. Here you will find the shape option. Just click on oval shape option. Just drag a oval shape, remove the outlines, guys, and now you have to click on effect option. Here you will find the soft edges option. Just click on that and choose a preset option and choose 25 point options from there. Now it's time to fill the shape with the color. So I'm going to fill it with some darker color, like I'm going to do fill it with this color. Or now I'm going to increase the points, like I'm going to make it 50 and drag it something like this, and maybe this much is good, or I'm going to make it transparent, like I'm going to transparent in something this much and put it over here, rotate it like this, and right click over here and send it to back. Now you can see the shadow effect at the bottom side. Okay, so this is how we have to create this shape, guys. So now what we have to do, we have to select all this text group from the previous slide, as well as this icon, this text group, and this. So I'm going to copy it and paste it over the slide and adjust it, like I'm going to put it over here. Now you can see I'm going to put it something here, guys. Okay, now we have to adjust, we have to keep this A text something here. And now I'm going to select all this shape and press Ctrl Z to make a single group, guys. Slightly I'm going to zoom in so that we can see the whole slide. Now what we have to do, we just have to duplicate it by pressing Ctrl D to the keyboard and flip it vertically. So I'm going to rotate option and flip it vertically like this. Now I'm going to put it over here, guys. Okay, we'll change this, so don't worry, we'll change the text over here, so there is no need to change worry about it. Now one more time we have to copy it, guys, so that we can put it in the center to get the three shapes like this. So I'm going to make a duplicate copy of this, put it over here, press Ctrl D and put it over here. So now what we have to do, we have to keep this at the center, keep this shape at the center like this. Okay, Now let me zoom in, guys. So make sure that your shape is in the center. To do that, I'm going to remove it and now put it over here and make sure that this shape should be in the center like this. And now I'm going to paste it by Control V. Put this shape over here. Maybe fill it with darker color like this, guys, or maybe some different color. So I'm going to fill it with a blue color. Remove it, guys, and make sure make sure that this shape should be in the center like this. Okay, this is in the center. And now Control V to put the blue shape over here. Put it over here, right click over here, guys, and click on edit point option. Just drag this point something here and drag this point something here, guys. Okay, so we have to do this for this shape. And now I'm going to fill it with the previous color. So I'm going to choose an eyedropper and fill it with this color, guys. Okay, so now I'm going to zoom out like this. Make sure that your text should be aligned, guys. So I'm going to put this text over here, put this option over here, and put this icon over here. You have to make changes with these two shapes also, these two text groups. So I'm going to put it over here and I'm going to put it this shape over here, guys. Okay, so now it's A, so we have to make it B. Sorry, guys, so we have to make it B. And now we have to rotate it, this text, to the 90 degrees, sorry. So I'm going to select this text, this, 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 and flip it vertically. So I'm going to flip it vertically like this. Okay. So now what you have to do, guys, I'm going to right click over here, just ungroup it, and after ungrouping it, I'm going to select this and this both shape and going to flip it vertically, guys, like this. Okay, and now I'm going to select this text, this one, and I'm going to flip it vertically like this. So I'm going to put this shape over here. You can see the icon, so I'm going to rotate it 180 degree like this and put it over here. Okay, and this option text we have to put it at the bottom like this, and here we have to rotate it 90 degree like this and put the option C. Now it's time to fill it with the color. So I'm going to press Control C, Control V, and put this shadow effect, rotate it like this, right click over here and send it to back. Now select this shape, okay, click on the shadow option and fill it with the shadow like I'm going to provide it shadow effect. Again, for this shape, I'm going to choose the same presets, and for this shape, I'm going to choose the same preset. There is no need to make changes with the transparency, size and blurnish. So I'm going to keep the blurnish as provided by default. Okay, so we have to keep something down like this, guys, and now it's time to fill it with a different color. So I'm going to zoom out, guys, and before doing this, let me show you which type of text I'm using. For this, I'm using this particular text and the size is 9. For the option, you can see square 721 BT and the size is 12. And for this option, I'm using the same text style, but the difference only is the size. And for this, I'm using Human 777 BLK and the size is 40. All these text styles are predefined or easily available in all the versions of the PowerPoint. So there is no need to get worried about the font size, guys, or font style. Okay, so now it's time to fill it with the color. So I'm going to choose this shape. For the right handle, what I'm going to use, I will use this color. And for the left handle, I will use the darker version of the same color. So I'm going to choose this color. Again, I'm going to choose more color option and drag this arrow to the down to make it darker. Okay, now for this shape, I'm going to choose this particular color for the right handle, and for the left handle, what color I'm going to use is the same color but the darker version of the same color. So I'm going to choose more color one more time and drag it to the down to make it darker. Click on OK to make it darker, guys, like this. Okay, so now your infographics is ready, guys. Now the only thing you have to do, the option one, this will be your option two or heading 2, and this will be the option 3 or heading 3. So here is the option 1, 2 available, so you can change it with this option to the heading. So I'm going to HEADING, I'm going to write it headings, or a title 1, title 2, title 3, whatever you want to add. So at the time of the editing this slide, you can make changes with the slide, guys. So that's all for today, and I hope you like the video. And if you really like the video, you learn a lot from this video, then please do share the video and keep watching, keep connected, stay tuned with us. Before concluding, I just want to make an announcement that I'm going to provide all these two slides in the link of these two download link. I'll provide the download link of these two slides in the description section. So go there, check out the description section and download these links from there. Use it in your project without any cost, without any attribution, and enjoy, guys. So that's all for today, guys. See you in the next tutorial. Till now, bye, and thank you very much for watching this video.